Today we are going to show you one part of pranayama breathing that Mira and I really love. It's called Bhramri, Bhramri Pranayama, which translates as the humming bee, the buzzing bee, the Indian bee, and all sorts of different bees, essentially because the sound that you are creating is reminiscent of a bee. What you do is you hum out as you do in Om chanting, but you close your mouth at the same time. I'll explain how it's done. You are going to put your hands into Shanmukhi Mudra, so your thumbs are going to go onto the tragus of your ear, so not inside the ear, but just on top of it, and then you close them off like this. Your index fingers and your middle fingers are closing off your eyes, and the remaining fingers are gently going onto your lips. Then you take a deep breath in and you hum out. So this is the first part. You can sit in Padmasana like I do, but if this is at all uncomfortable to you, you can also be in Shukasana or you can be in Vajrasana, anything essentially that doesn't constrict your diaphragm, any meditative position that you assume and that maybe you find more comfortable than Padmasana, the lotus position. This part, which I've just showed you, is referred to as the male bee because there's also a female bee. It's slightly higher and it will always be higher no matter how your voice is pitched because you are humming in. I'll demonstrate this. So it's a little bit difficult if you haven't done it before because we're not used to humming and we're very much used to humming out, and as we speak we're letting go of air, but we rarely pace ourselves when we take in air. What we do sometimes when we're shocked is we go so we're capable of making sound as we breathe in, and we can try it like that and then get ourselves to pace ourselves doing this sound. So with an open mouth, then you can do the same with a closed mouth. And you can prolong the sound and just go. And you'll automatically feel that the sound is not just coming from up here. You're not just using your intercostal and clavicular breathing. You'll use your diaphragmatic breathing. And that way you're engaging all of your lungs, especially the larger lower area of the lungs, which is used when you use diaphragmatic breathing. You can put these two together, the male bee and the female bee, and just, we can do it together, all of us now. Breathing out first because it's easier, then in, then out again, and then in. So closing your ears with your thumbs, your eyes with your forefingers and middle fingers, and your mouth with your ring finger and pinky. Take a deep breath in. So I suggest for the first time you try this, you shouldn't go for longer than 5 rounds. You can start with a couple of rounds or something like that and then take it further and further. Like all of pranayama, this is a very, very good exercise for you to release stress. It activates your vagus nerve even faster than some other pranayama breathing exercises because you're also using your vocal cords, which is the fastest way to tell your brain to stop producing stress hormones, adrenaline, cortisol, and start producing oxytocin and endorphins instead. It's also, in addition to that, you know, it's very good for your blood pressure. It reduces your blood pressure. Studies have shown that Bhramri Pranayama also immediately sinks, lowers your heart rate. So not as a delayed effect, but also the first time you do it instantaneously, so to speak. It's safe to do if you're pregnant, and it can actually facilitate childbirth as well. It helps your concentration due to this one-pointed focus. And the great thing about closing off in Shanmukhi Mudra, closing off all of your, you know, having no light come towards your eyes, is also that you're entirely inside your own head. So it's very good against headaches and against migraines. It's very good against anxiety. Some studies have shown that it's good against Alzheimer's. And what else? So alleviates stress, good against your blood pressure, lowers your blood pressure. And one more thing. So if you don't use Shanmukhi Mudra, or if you want to combine it with Jalandhaband, with your chin lock like that, it's also very good to cure thyroid problems that you might have. So anything with this particular position regulates the blood flow to your thyroid and is very good for it. And that's pretty much it. I love it, and I hope you do too. Thank you.